I'll just soften the greens a touch.
Yeah, absolutely.
Now, Eduardo.
Oh, look at this.
Oh, hello.
There we go.
Look at that.
It's going to be our leader. Championship leader.
Who will make the first birdie of the championship?
If I'm in trouble, just play for a five. Play for a bogey and with a bit of luck, you get out with the odd four.
Eduardo Molinari is the man who makes the first birdie. All right, Trevor, we saw Francesco a little bit earlier. How about his brother, Eduardo? Got off to a birdie start. Here he is in the eighth, but now he's three over par.
Yeah, the first group. Flag right on the front. Just over the bunker on the downslope. That is as good as it gets.
Really good shot there.
He's getting better.
Oh, yes.
Hang on.
Come on now.
Or maybe we...
With his brother, Eduardo, at the 10th.
Whoa! Whoa, look at that.
That's five.
So he birdies one, and then he slam dunks one for birdie at 10.
Why not?
Three straight birdies for Eduardo.
This is older brother Eduardo for birdie at 13.
How about it?
Come on. The third of the day. At what is a very difficult par five.
Eduardo Molinari and Francesco in the field this week. Lengthy birdie putt at 14. And a perfect one.
And at the seventh, Russell Henley for birdie. Yet another Georgia Bulldog. We're going to have to count and see how many of these guys are in the field.
I have a lot of 4, 5, 6 footers. Russell Henley, this for birdie and sole possession. Played a break there and perfectly done. So this man's got it to 3 under and out there by himself.
Boy, look at that, wide open. Looks like he's going to hit it on the hosel. Slide it left, get that ball up quick. And look at that, even that, I mean, that was played perfectly. That you couldn't play that any better.
He's got this break in just a little bit to his right. Should start going right there. Yep. Good up and down there after coming up short right in the bunker.
He's had 3 top fives this season on the PGA Tour, 2/3 and a 4th. Missed the cut in his last start at the Memorial, but that a nice putt.
Russell Henley, an opportunity, saw that shot in here for birdie. So he will stay one back. Good day so far for Russell Henley. This is 2nd at 15. They have a new tee now, stretch that out.
Yeah, they're playing a forward tee today because of this back right hole location. Beautiful shot there by Henley.
Henley for birdie and a share at 15. Saw that shot in there. And what a beautiful approach.
This is at 16. Russell Henley for par to stay in a share of the lead and just does get it to go.
Hill, we've seen it already today. This for a birdie in the outright lead. This is quick. Well judged.
So should be a par for Russell.
Speaking of going for it, at 18, Russell Henley. Par 5, going after it in 2.
Asking for it to bite, so he flushed it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Good shot. If it catches, no, it's just going to trickle over. Okay, the lie's not too bad right in that area right there.
Henley, this his 3rd.
Yeah, he's going to try and kind of blast this. No, he just kind of more of a chipping motion. I thought he might take it a little further up in the air, but landed on the downslope. That's pretty good from there.
Here at 18, Russell Henley, his 8th start at the U.S. Open. Best finish, sure, 16th in 2010. Yeah, solid birdie to finish up after reaching into it, the par 5, 67.
Sounded like it's coming back. Yeah.
It's pounded down there.
good start for Brooks.
Ball slightly below his feet.
Have to carry it all the way, Trevor, from the left side of the fairway.
Yeah, you got to come up and over that shoulder there. There's some room just right of this hole location, right there. Perfectly played from Koepka. That's leaving him an uphill putt as well. And this was just earlier, Steve. Brooks Koepka for birdie. Big breaker from his right-hand side. Has it got enough speed? It sure does. We've seen a few birdies here at the 12th already.
Top three. Koepka on the way.
Just a little feel shot.
Boy, that's such a cool shot. I mean, this whole location sits up on a little perch on a plateau.
10 paces ahead from the left-hand side of the fairway, pitching wedge in hand. I'm going out that one pretty full. Leaking a tad right.
Not much. Not much wrong with that. Koepka with it, 5 of 7 fairways in the front nine, 8 of 9 greens.
Man, didn't like that immediately, obviously.
It's amazing to watch him at major championships.
Back at the second, Brooks Koepka now with his second shot.
Yeah, just trying to flight that down a little bit from 106 yards and playing it to the smart side of the hole.
Good shot for Brooks. Yeah, he's something special in these major championships, isn't he? 17 and 18, this for birdie and the solo lead. It's just incredible to watch his focus, the way that he moves around the golf course. He moves like he owns it.
Going with the putter. This also very fast, particularly the first half of the putt and a big left to right swing. Really caught too much of that.
You see that bobble come out of the rough.
Mm-hmm. This could very well be one of his longer par putts today. Wow. Made that look easy.
Koepka, good decent up and down here in 6.
Oh, good try, but he's going to make bogey there. No surprise, 7 is a very difficult hole. If you don't drive it in the fairway, it's you're just scrambling to make 4s there. So he'll drop out of a share of the lead. Now one back.
Even though technically JT is further away, Koepka's first love is baseball, and he's got to conjure up a baseball yeah. swing.
Justin, how difficult is this?
Well, the challenge is the club's coming in so flat, it's easy for the grass to wrap around the shaft and the hosel. Strong hands, strong arms. It helped him again there, able to keep that club from twisting over.
Wow, what
you
a touch.
You want to say it or you want me to?
That was a U.S. Open par.
There you go.
Yes.
And a Koepka par at the U.S. Yeah. Open. We've seen him do it time and again.
He's widening his stance to try to get lower and get more comfortable.
That was
really, really well done. I mean, a little bad luck that it hit the ridge where it did, but that was executed beautifully. He liked the way he hit it. He just doesn't like where it ended up.
Yeah, Justin, we were talking about whenever I have a chance on a questionable layup or going at. Koepka now up this hill again.
Well, that was a beautiful putt.
Yeah, that was, dare I say it, better than most.
Well, that seemed like a pretty nonchalant round of 2 under, didn't it?
Yeah.
You have to use that sparingly, Jake.
Trevor, I thought a death knell at this golf course would be chipping downhill, I thought. And I think you see a lot of players trying to get it 30, 40 feet below the hole here on 12 today to this back pin.
Yeah, that's a great call and strategy throughout the golf course. Anything along here at the south course is really going to struggle. But this is a beauty from Shoffley, just as John described, leaving it short of the hole.
Doinked it off of that.
Nice look for Shoffley here at 12. And right into the heart.
Nice rhythm in that stroke, Trevor.
Should move to the left, I'd imagine, a little bit.
Absolutely.
Maybe more than a little bit.
Not quite that much.
At 14 now, Xander Shoffley.
After a gorgeous low iron through the wind here, about 6 feet for birdie. Beautiful.
How about that? To get the home crowd fired up. A man from San Diego.
Kurt, he just watched Max Homa's ball get knocked right out of the air. Probably prompted him to club up about 5 or 6 yards if he could control it.
Yeah, that's a good one there. There's some slope behind this hole. This could get really good. This may end up right down next to the hole by the time it's done. Excellent shot for Shoffley. Xander Shoffley for his birdie here at 16.
Nice.
Yeah, no problem there. Boy, he is doing what he needs to do.
After a huge drive, only 219 front, 238 hole. This is a laser, Justin.
Wow, right into that upslope. Beautiful shot.
Poorest putt of the day. Not even close.
Around 180 for Shoffley. And this fairway bunkers really aren't too bad. Relatively flat. Let's tuck that one.
Beautiful. Xander trying to win here in his hometown. It's happened before in San Diego. The great Mickey Wright back in 1964.
52 degree wedge for Xander. Got a little ridge, 15 feet short, he needs to carry. If it does that, it will skip towards the hole. Take the side slope.
Well, you get such a short iron in your hand, you can always be aggressive.
At the six for Shoffley to get to 3 under and share of the lead. Well, look how quick these greens are getting. We've seen a lot of players with trouble down here. This one is fairly short enough, I think he can handle it. That well judged.
We saw Eduardo a little bit earlier. Here's his brother, Francesco.
As I was saying earlier on, this could be huge for the European team if Molinari and Tommy Fleetwood are not their partner together, considering the damage they did in Paris.
What a duo they were. Wow. Francesco. Eduardo birdied his first hole, and his brother did the same. Yeah, look at that.
That's got to be a first.
Less green to work with from his position.
It's just, there's just nothing there. It's really difficult. You cannot miss it in that right bunker. It is just too difficult.
It's just inside 15 feet downhill.
Is it going to slide? Ah, oh, beautiful. Wow. Great read.
His brother both having good days out here in round one. Yeah, there you go. We haven't seen many birdie putts made at 16 today, but Francesco Molinari gets one to go.
Molinari from the bunker. Francesco.
Oh, nicely done there. Open it on the way back. Kept the speed going through it.
Very nice to see you playing well, Francesca. Three under 68. Take that all day long. A share of second, one off the lead.
This is at 13. Cabrera Bayo for his birdie.
Hey, thanks. Thanks, but we're in break. But you are really good.
You just never know.
Making the turn, Rafa Cabrera Bayo, the 37-year-old from Spain. Third at the par five.
And throwing it over that ridge. The back of the green just perfectly.
Hello. One way to make eagle. See three of them today there. First one from off the green.
And over it too, Cabrera Bayo with his second shot. Good angle to that back right hole location. Yeah. Yeah. Really good. So after that chip in eagle at the 18th.
Birdie would get him tied for the lead. A much longer birdie putt than he would have liked. Very slow going uphill.
Still well judged. He's the only player in the morning wave to be bogey free. And back at 9, Cabrera Bayo finishing out for a par for beautiful round of three under. Kay mentioned that he started last year 68-70 to be in the mix, but his weekend was 74-78 to finish in a tie for 23rd.
Big rip here, but also caught in this left-right hurting wind. This will miss in the rough.
It settles in.
Masiyama's second.
133 back into the wind. Tough pin to get to. You just got to get the right distance. If you go long, it's just a tough, tough chip.
And that'll feed. That'll feed to the left. That'll get down there, and that makes that putt ever. Each time it rolls to the closer to that hole, it takes some of that break out of it. Breaking to his left. Should give this a good look.
Let's see. I'm going to get the one under.
Yeah. There's one thing about his game that holds him back at times. It's that club, because getting to the green, never a problem.
Boy, not flighted at all. Took it straight up in the air, but it's on a good looking line if they get the number right.
Oh, he did just get it right. Wow. It actually landed in the rough. And that helped it, kept it from running past the hole. Boom, there you go.
Paul, that start stop. So this flow, I think, helps this area of the putting so much better.
Matsuyama for birdie to get the two under.
Case in point spot, and it moved to the right.
Par putt for Matsuyama, drills it.
Now Henley, the fewest in at 67.
At the seventh, the Masters champion. Oh, just needed to catch a little of the flag stick, and that would have been swallowed.
Back at seven,
Matsuyama for the par. Doesn't touch the hole.
Slip out for par here.
Oh boy.
Mm.
That's tough.
Just look to peek at that one just a little bit.
Really good line.
Matsuyama for birdie to get back to under par for the championship.
There you go.
Pretty.
Yep, a good start. And Hideki's over at the 11th for birdie.
I got to say, I never imagined that Hideki could win a major.
Whoa!
bogey.
He steals one at 11, just the fourth birdie of the day at this par three.
There's so much pressure on the Japanese players to perform, but you know, after he did it and you reflect back, you know, he's always one of the last guys to leave the property. He practices, he works as hard as anybody in the game.
Matsuyama playing his third from just short of the green, electing to putt.
To put a shoulder turn on
this
one.
Well, he made a big backswing. Let's see if it was enough. That's pretty well judged.
Yes, it is.
Mm-hmm.
Clearly, he can get to 18, and I think he can get to 13 with a little bit of helping wind. And Hideki, nice solid par, even though he had one off the label there off the bat, little mishit on his second shot, but.
Matsuyama over at the 15th.
Taking dead aim. That's how you do it.
Matsuyama with a chance to move within one.
That's be a heck of a save after hitting at that hay on the right. And he's done it. Big time par.
Crowd recognizes it too.
So two club gap, you don't often see that with these guys.
Right of it, trying to draw. Good line.
Yeah, beautiful shot. Beautiful shot from the Masters champion.
Oh, I put it right on him.
Yeah, well, it was a good stroke.
Matsuyama for birdie, Bones.
And let's see if he learned from that putt that Bryson had.
Yeah, he pushed that. He got that one started a little right.
Right of the flag.
Oh, he took a big swipe at that. He was able to stop it right back there.
So great club selection.
Yep. This putt is pretty fast. I've seen a couple guys blow it by, but it barely moves left. Easy.
Good call there.
Well, I'm not surprised though. I mean, it's a pretty tough golf course. Oh, ooh, I thought he pulled it.
Got it in there. So it's another good day in a major for Hideki Matsuyama, who won the Masters.
John Rahm, his second.
Just such a great ball striker and really a great attitude. I mean, the way he handled that whole situation at Memorial and then even in his presser earlier in the week.
Rahm for birdie. Would you make him the favorite this week?
Yes, absolutely.
Should be all right. Here's Rahm now, his third shot at 13. It's a pretty good one.
Just watch out for any one of the three to get red hot. I think Rahm's probably here. It might be a revenge week for him.
Yeah. He's definitely got more motivation than anybody else, having played so well.
Saw Cantley earlier. He was the guy that took advantage of Rahm, having to withdraw because of testing positive for COVID with a six-shot lead. Headed into that final round. Rahm, you talked about revenge after having that taken away from him, but he handled it brilliantly, said it happens.
This is John Rahm's third. Look where he's playing this thing, way back behind his right foot. Try to chop it, just get it to the top of the slope right about there. See if it'll release to the hole. Oh, and it doesn't. Third shot came up well short, so downhill, tricky putt here for par. Oh, yeah. Boy, do you need to do that to win a U.S. Open, don't you, Paul? You're going to have a lot of those par
putts. Sit.
Attaboy.
Oh.
A different putter than he was using earlier in the season. One that has the same neck on it that the putter that he used until this year.
G-
guest of the Zingers.
This is a fun shot, Gary.
Yeah, look at this. He's going to play it way up to the left and utilize the slope. Now, I'm going to tell you that not only takes touch and technique, it takes imagination.
Wow.
What a shot. Another hole where the scoreboard left there is illuminating the green, making it a little easier.
The challenge here is to fly it all the way back.
Yeah,
there.
Got to control the distance. Easy to come up short. Ooh, he did.
Boy.
Well played shot.
That's got to go.
Yeah. But going to be a solid opening round of 69. Going to be the third consecutive year that he's opened with 69 in the U.S. Open. Back in 2019, it led to a tie for third.
When he was quarantining for COVID, Gary, I mean, it's a long time, but he spent like, what, a week without touching clubs? He was actually playing on a simulator.
Wow. What an action that is. Good result below the hole.
So that Kikuyu is the one that's the most feared, the tall rye and the Poe.
Yep, and over at 12, Oosthuizen with a putt for a rare birdie here at this long par four. And Oosthuizen moves it to even par. All right, over at 16.
And Louis Oosthuizen with a rare shot short of the hole here. This for birdie. Beautifully done. Takes advantage of the uphill putt.
Over here at 17, Oosthuizen with a chance to reach two under. Yeah. He's been playing some great golf of late. It was right there at the PGA Championship. Ended up in a tie for second behind Phil Mickelson.
Yeah. Louis just kind of under the radar with that third place finish at the U.S. Open last fall at Wingfoot.
He's kind of quietly become one of the best putters in the world.
That one's tracking. Beautiful touch by Louis. So that is going to be three birdies in a row for Oosthuizen to get to three under. And that one dropped. He would have tied Henley and become just the second player to get to four under. So another major, and it's going well again.
And Oosthuizen with a very makeable putt here for birdie. This is a chance to tie the lead. A little downhill, a little movement right away.
Got to be careful. Guard against going long.
Yes, you bitchy.
That beauty.
That's fantastic.
The latest chance for Oosthuizen to catch Henley at the top.
This will be his third really good opportunity in a row.
Yes!
There it is. Finally, Henley is caught. He wasn't just taking a picture of Mickelson's calves.
No.
Okay.
All right. Oosthuizen with a chance to take the outright lead here at six. And that one down the hill and drifts on by.
I didn't see that coming. I thought he was going to fly it there and spin it.
What do you think of this play?
Hey, I'll tell you.
Tell you in a second. That's a fantastic play.
That's fabulous.
Oh my goodness, David!
Totally fabulous.
What a touch from there, coming off that slow surface. There's Kikuyu in the fairways.